Welcome, everyone. My name is Nisha, for those of you who don't know me already. I'm from nishawallamy.com. I teach freelancers and designers how to streamline their client process so that they can finally live the life that they crave, a life of more money, more time, more creativity. A lot of you have been asking me about Dubsado. So I'm going to be sharing what Dubsado is, why everyone is going crazy over it, and who should and should not be using it. So before I even jump into that, I have a question for you. Do you already use Dubsado, or have you even heard of it? Go ahead and comment, let me know what you think of it. And while you do that, I just want to take this time to also let you know that I've got 20% off of Dubsado for you guys if you use my affiliate code. And the link is inside of this post. For those of you who've heard of it and you're not really sure what it is, maybe you're curious, Dubsado is an all-in-one business management suite. So if you've ever wanted to handle all the client process things like project management, contracts, appointment scheduling, bookkeeping, questionnaires, etc., all from one place, then this is the perfect tool to allow you to do that. So no more bouncing around from tool to tool, bookmarking them in your browser, none of that nonsense. If you don't want to do that, then you can pay to use a tool like this. So what exactly can it even do? Well, that is what I'm here to share with you guys. And instead of me talking about it and trying to explain it to you without any kind of visual aspect, because that would be a bit silly, I'm just going to screen share basically. I'm going to share not my account, but I'm going to share a trial account that I really quickly set up today so that I can walk you through an overview of some of the features. So this is the Dubsado dashboard. And as you can see, there's some really handy things in here. So I'll start off with the days of the week at the top. As you can see your week at a glance, and you can sync Dubsado with your own calendar, regardless of whether you use Google Calendar, your Apple Calendar, whatever it is, you can sync it like that. And then your synced tasks, so whatever is in the calendar that you regularly use on a daily basis, they will appear marked with that yellow mark at the side of them. So you'll see those inside of Dubsado. Now on the bottom left, you can see that there's a to-do list, and that's basically so that you can add to-dos if you want to straight from your dashboard without going into the to-do list section of Dubsado. And then you can also see this section right here, unread alerts. And so basically when somebody signs your contract or a client has paid your invoice, you'll get an alert and you'll be able to see it in this section. And then finally, if we move over to the right side of the Dubsado dashboard, you'll see a financial overview. And that is just basically to show you how much money you've earned so far in the year and how much money you're projected to earn based on the amounts of money inside of your invoices that haven't been paid yet. And it'll obviously show you your grand total as well. Okay, so let me move on over to this little section on the side of the website where you can see all of the other sections of Dubsado. And by the way, you guys, if you have any questions, post them in the comment section or give me a thumbs up if you're really liking this tool, you love the look of it, and you might try it out yourself. So you can see there's this section, leads. A lead is a potential client. So it's somebody who hasn't actually booked a spot in your schedule yet. And inside of the lead section, you'll see some basic information about those leads. So you'll see the title of the project, the client's name and the date. You'll also see the amount that this project is worth, whether you have sent them a contract and whether it has been signed yet, and you'll see other fun things like workflows and things like that. If we move on to jobs, it looks really similar to leads, but the main difference here, because I find that the friends that I've spoken to and the designers that I've hopped on Skype with to talk about this tool, a lot of them get confused as to what the difference is between leads and jobs. So think of it this way: a lead is a potential client and a job is a booked client, basically. And in here, you'll have all of your booked clients. You'll have all of the same information that you just saw for the leads. And if you click a client, here's some information that you'll see about the project. So you'll see the client's name, you'll see whether you've given them a password to log into their client portal. You'll see their invoices, any forms that you've sent to them, any appointments that they've booked with you, and so on. Then we'll move on to bookkeeping. I do want to say that Dubsado's bookkeeping is really basic. So if you want to do more like in-depth bookkeeping, you will need to use a different tool. And at the moment, Dubsado only syncs with QuickBooks, but I know that they have it in the pipeline to also sync with Wave Apps, which is what I use for my bookkeeping, and also Xero. So if you use either of those, they are coming to Dubsado soon. For now though, you can either just use the basic bookkeeping inside of Dubsado, or you can use QuickBooks and sync it with Dubsado. So when you sync it, anybody who pays an invoice in Dubsado, that will then be added to your QuickBooks. And inside of Dubsado, you can basically do bookkeeping like it allows you to see your profit and loss statement, your chart of accounts, all of your sales, different things like that, and send invoices, proposals, all that good stuff. So next up on this list is the calendar. And here you can see your tasks at a glance in a calendar view. Now, if anybody's been using Asana, then you'll be used to this kind of view. And all of these orange tasks, by the way, are basically tasks that Dubsado has pulled in from my Google Calendar. So you can see all of those tasks from your outside external calendar inside of Dubsado, as well as any tasks that you want to manually add to the calendar, which I think is a really good feature. And then we will move on to the forms. So basically you can create a form for your client and you can embed it on your website. Or if you want to, you can just send your clients the link to the form. It's as simple as that. Then we've got tasks, where you can add tasks and you can view them in a list format. Now, again, if you're used to Asana, you'll be used to using this because Asana looks really similar to this. So you can sort out your tasks in a list format and you can simply click the tick to mark it as done. You can also assign it to you or somebody else, so you can give it a due date. And if you don't want to view the tasks in a list format, you can also view it in a boards format. Then you've got the address book, which if you have ever struggled to find a place to put all of your clients' personal information, so I'm talking like their name, their address, their email address, things like that. If you've ever like struggled to find a place to put all of that, or you keep like putting it in places here and there, and this Evernote and this Google Doc and this notebook, then you can stop that completely, just add them all into the address book inside of Dubsado. And whenever people ask me, well, why do I really need my client's address? The simple answer is because if you want to send your client a client gift, like I know that a lot of you do, and I 100% back you on that, I commend you for that, is such a good way to wow your clients at the end of your projects. But if you're going to be doing that, then simply ask the client for their address in the questionnaire that you send them at the start of the project and the rest of their personal information. Then you could just add it to your address book. Then there's the time tracker for those of you who like to track how many hours you spend on each of your projects. I really recommend that. You don't have to do all the time, but I always feel like freelancers should at least time a couple of their projects just to be sure that their hourly rate is actually what they're earning, and they're not earning any less than that because they're spending too much time, or more time than they thought they were, on their client projects. And then lastly, you can see this feature down on the left under templates. And this is what I get really excited about inside of Dubsado, because I just love this. It's basically the section where all of your templates are stored. So you'll see that you will have templates for forms. So that could be like your questionnaires and things like that. You've also got a section for canned emails. So if you've got email scripts that you like to send to your clients and you find yourself saying the same thing to each client over and over again, just put them into email scripts and then you can set those up inside of the canned email section of Dubsado. Then we've got the packages section, and that is basically if you ever find yourself typing out the same packages onto all of your invoices all the time when there's really no need because you offer the same services or the same packages to your clients, then you can basically just create those packages once inside of that section, and then you can just add those to your invoices and to your contracts or wherever you want to add them in the future with just a few clicks. You don't have to keep on typing things out. Then there's the invoices section, there's the tax items workflow, there's payment schedules, and there is the template library. And the template library is really cool. I'll just click onto it for you. The template library is awesome because it allows you to use other people's templates. So if we just scroll down, you can see there's like template questionnaires for web designers. So there's the web design content planner, there's the general feedback questionnaire, the web design project questionnaire, there's even a website design contract. So depending on what you're offering, you can use a template from within Dubsado, and they are actually legit templates. So you don't have to worry about them not being legit at all because they are. Yeah, so basically, oh yeah, the couple of things that I did actually miss out is that number one, your contracts you can send from Dubsado for e-signature, so you don't have to like send them to the client for the client to print it, sign it, scan it, send it back to you. You can send it for e-signature from right inside of Dubsado itself. And I also wanted to tell you that you can brand everything that's inside of Dubsado with your own logo and your own color palette. And you can create client portal. So yeah, you can create a client portal where your client can also stay organized with the project. So it's not just you on the back end staying organized and the client feeling like they are in utter chaos, not really knowing what's going on. Who is Dubsado for and who isn't it for? If you have the budget to spend on this tool, it's $25 a month. So if you have the budget for spending on a tool like this, then I really, really recommend it. I think it's well worth it. But if you're starting out and you don't have much money to spend on your business, or you're not bringing in very many clients at the moment and you're kind of struggling, then that's when I would recommend to just stick to free tools. So again, if you loved this video, go ahead and give it a like on Facebook. If you're watching it on YouTube, be sure to subscribe and give me a thumbs up to show everybody and me that you enjoyed this video. Want to learn exactly how to set up Dubsado for your freelance business? Well, Dubsado comes with a bit of a learning curve, but with my course, Dubsado in a Day, you'll get set up easily and quickly. Your client process will go from overwhelming to organized in as little as a day. Head to learnwithnisha.com/Dubsado or use the link below to learn more and join.